Hello, this is VG Shanmugapriya. Now we are going to see about ClassPro tool, a tool for protein-protein docking. This is my first video and I have planned to upload videos on bioinformatic tools. Kindly subscribe to my channel. The information and the details what I am going to talk about this tool is taken from this paper, the ClassPro web server for protein-protein docking. This tool works on direct docking method. Given two protein structures, it tries to find out their complex structure based on their energy. It tries to find out the low energy complex structure. Here, it doesn't use any known protein-protein complex structure as template. Hence, it is called as a direct docking method. Here, it gives good results for those proteins which undergo only moderate conformational change when they form a complex. So here studies have shown that this tool works good for enzyme inhibitor pairs and antibody antigen pairs. We'll first see to the basic steps of the tool. Here, given two protein structures, the tool uses a program called Piper and it does a rigid body docking, where here it creates billions of conformation of the protein complex and it calculates their energy based on fast Fourier transformation approach. The scoring function here, the energy function is based on shape complementarity, electrostatic interaction and desolvation contribution. Having different conformations of the protein-protein complex and their energies, it now retains only 1000 lowest energy structure. Now these structures are now clustered and then a model for each cluster is generated and this model is then energy minimized. So now let's go into the explanation. Given two proteins, one as receptor and one as ligand, the Piper program will first take the receptor protein in a fixed grid and the ligand protein in a movable grid and it does docking, right? Now, the ligand protein being in a movable grid, it undergoes translational and rotational movement. So here I have shown in the second figure what is rotational and translational movement. Rotational is you imagine a wheel being rotated so that you call it as rotational movement. And when it rotates, it moves forward. That you call it as translational movement. So the ligand undergoes rotational and translational movement in all directions. To say it undergoes 70,000 rotations, okay, in all Euler angles and it the step size of the translational movement is 1 angstrom. So the average size protein, a ligand protein now, it will undergo 10 to the power 10 conformations and all these conformations of the ligand are being docked with their receptor protein and the energy is calculated. For the different docking conformations, the interacting energy is written in the form of correlation function, which is calculated using FFTs, right? The formula for calculating the energy between the two proteins is provided here. Here the energy terms, four energy terms are given. The first two energy terms indicate van der Waals interaction energy. The third energy term indicates electrostatic interaction energy and the fourth one, EDARS, it represents the desolvation energy term. The weights provided for the energy terms will differ according to different types of docking problems. This table shows the different weights provided to these different energy terms, that is repulsion, attraction, electrostatic and desolvation. So for these energy terms in different energy coefficient sets. So these are the energy coefficient sets. So for each coefficient set, you have different weights for these energy terms. So this coefficient set, you can also call it as scoring scheme, or you can call it as, in simple words, as docking modes, different docking modes. So here, so when a general submission of two protein is done, the program generates four sets of models. Okay, these four. It four sets of models based on these four scoring schemes. And scoring schemes are four docking modes, and for each individual set, low energy structures are selected and clustered. So you will have four results. When other mode in advanced option is selected, the models are generated by this last three docking modes and low energy structures are selected and they are gathered together for clustering. So you will have a single result. So for the different docking conformations of the two proteins, energy is calculated and only 1000 lowest energy dock structures are retained. Next, it calculates interface RMSD between these 1000 structures. the structure that has highest number of neighbors within a 9 angstrom RMSD radius is now defined as the center of the first cluster. Means each dog structure is taken and then it is compared with all other structures. There will be similar structure which will differ with it only with the difference will be within only 9 angstrom. So these two structures will be now considered as the neighbor. Like that it will search for each structure how many neighbors are there. So any structure which has more number of neighbors will be the center of the first cluster. So that cluster will be now removed and then it will search for the next structure which has more number of neighbors. That will be the second cluster. Like that it creates approximately 30 clusters. And after clustering, the center structure of each cluster will be energy minimized and that will be given to you as the model. So in the output, the energy of the center structure of the cluster as well as the energy of any lowest energy structure in the cluster will be provided. This is the home page of ClusPro. You can use it without registering through this link, or you can register here and then you can log inside. The advantage of registering is your results won't be accessed by anyone. Only you can view your results. Whereas here, when you submit your jobs here, your results can be viewed by anyone. Okay, but to register here, you need to have your academic email ID. So now, I have already registered. So here, you need to submit your proteins. First, you need to give job name. You can give any name here. And keep this as default, server CPU as default. You need to now enter your receptor PDP ID and the ligand PDP ID. When you are submitting two proteins, preferably keep the larger protein as receptor and the smaller protein as ligand. Now I have entered the PDP ID of my receptor protein and ligand protein. I have taken coronavirus spike protein domain region as receptor and a human aggregation prone protein tau as ligand. Now you know proteins in PDP, they are either found as individual proteins or they are in complex with other proteins. So here and now in methods like NMR, when the structure is predicted, you will be having ensemble of the same polypeptide chain. So there will be multiple copies of the same chain. To be specific, you need to enter the chain names here, right? But if you don't enter the chain names, all the chains will be considered for docking here. Now I'll show you how to identify the chain what we have to enter here. So here go to PDP database and enter the PDP ID. Here the protein what I'm going to use as a receptor is coronavirus spike protein. Now you see in this PDP it is in a complex structure. The spike protein is there along with ACE protein. This is the human receptor protein, right? Now you can see there are two chains over here. So I need to know which is my receptor chain. So here, which I am going to enter as the receptor. Now scrolling down, I see this A chain belongs to this ACE protein. So here only A is written, means it is A chain belongs to this protein. Coming over here, it is chain B, which is the spike protein. So the second chain is my spike protein, but it is authored as E. You need to use E here. Okay, to confirm this, what I do is, display the PDP format. Now here, when you scroll down, what you see is, you see chain A. It belongs to that ACE protein, right? Now scroll down again over here, what you see is chain E. So this E is our spike protein. Okay, now what I do, I enter here chain E. Now coming here, the ligand protein 6QJH. Again, I need to confirm whether it is a complex structure or it is having only a single chain. The ligand protein ID is again entered in PDP database. And now see here, it is the tau protein, but many filaments are seen. You get the information from here that it is homotrimer. Three polypeptide chains are present together. Okay, right. Now
To know the chain names, what I do is scroll down. Here, okay, there are three chains, A, C and B. Now, both A and C are authored as B and B is authored as C. So, what I do is, I take the B, the one, the single chain here. So, I enter C in this chain ID. And now, I go for docking. Also, now, I will tell you what are the different advanced options and what are the functions.
When you click on the advanced options, it will display this list of options. Let's see them one by one. Under attraction and repulsion option, if suppose you know that some of the residues are involved in binding of the two proteins, experimentally known, then what you can do is you can enter those residues under attraction. And if some residues are known that they are not involved in binding or they are on the surface of the protein after the complex has been formed, if you are very sure of about that, then you can enter the repulsion residues. And for doing this, you need to enter the chain ID, chain name, and the hyphen, the residue number, as shown here. Also, for repulsive residues, you can either enter the residues or you can upload a PDP file which contains those repulsive residues. And this mode can be combined with other advanced options also. Structure modification option. When you think that your protein, your submitted protein has some tagged residues at the terminals or the terminal residues are not modeled properly, then you can choose this option. So the tool will remove the terminal residues until it comes near a secondary structure. And then this modification can be done both for receptor and the ligand or for both. Multimer docking option. If you want to model a HOMO multimer, then you have to upload the protein with a single chain as receptor protein and then you have to choose this option. To get a dimer complex, enter 2 in the box and for trimer, enter 3. Here, the attractive and repulsion option can also be added. Antibody mode option. When you want to dock an antibody and antigen, you need to choose this mode. Antibody protein should be loaded as receptor and antigen as ligand. When you choose this option, the program uses an asymmetric interaction statistics for energy calculation. Also, to get precise result, either you select the automatically mask non-CDR region box or use attractive and repulsion option to mask non-CDR residues. Others mode option. Interaction energy of some of the protein-protein complexes cannot be described by van der Waals, electrostatic or hydrophobic energy coefficient. For such type of proteins, when you are submitting it, choose this option. As seen before, in different energy terms, for this option, three set of weighing coefficients will be used and the 500 lowest energy structures from each result will be combined and then they will be taken together for clustering. Next, heparin ligand option. Heparin is a polysaccharide. If you want to dock heparin with a protein, choose this option. Load the protein as receptor and choose this option. Restraints option. Here, if pairwise distance between interacting atoms are known, that information can be provided and only the docked complex structures which agree with the restraints provided will be given in the results. Similarly, in SACS profile option, if SACS experimental data are provided about the complex structure, then only docked complexes which agree with it will be provided in the results. Once you submit your job for docking, you can check the job status in queue here. So it will display all the running jobs. And once the jobs are complete, it will be shifted to this result page. Here you can see the finished jobs. You can access your result through it. If you have registered, then after completion of job, it will come to your mail. So through that link, you can directly go to the result page here. So this is now the result page. So here, this job status, first when you open this, what you can see is, you can see the status of your job as finished and then the submission details. It also shows the PDB input, whatever you have loaded, it will show those structures, original structures. And then whatever chain you have mentioned,
that single chain will be taken and other processing will be done, and it will be displaying the process files. Other processing in the sense, it will remove the hetero atoms, it will like ions and water molecules, any other ligands if they are present, and only the chain what you have mentioned will be seen now here. Okay, and if you have also opted for an advanced option of trimming of your terminal ends, so all those will be done, and this is the final structure of the proteins which will be taken now for docking purpose. Going back to the result page, these are the 10 models which are displayed now, 0 to 9, right, got from this balanced energy coefficient. If you have no prior information on the nature of interaction of those two proteins, then it is better to go with this balanced result. Or if you have any information regarding the nature of the protein-protein interaction, then you can choose other energy modes like electrostatic favored, hydrophobic, van der Waals and electrostatic. Let's see this balanced docking mode results. For this, first click the view models course. You can see here the weights given to energy terms for balanced docking mode energy coefficient. And now you can see there are 0 to 29 clusters, right? So there are total of 30 clusters, and here these are the members of each cluster. So here you can see, based on the numbers, that the clusters are ranked based on the number of members in each cluster. Here you can see the docking energy scores. Note that for each cluster, two energy scores are given. The first energy score belongs to the central structure of the cluster, and the second energy score is the score of the lowest energy structure in the cluster. The model provided in the results belongs to this center structure of the cluster, which is energy minimized, right? Now, important studies have shown that the near native structure of the docked complex are found in these 10 clusters only. So now what we do is, the first thing is, as the first cluster, that is the zero cluster, has more number of members in it, we assume that that model represents the near native structure. Also, the other thing what we can do is, in the 10 clusters, just see which one has the lowest energy. Now here, in our results, you can see that this 7th cluster has the lowest energy level. Now we can also consider the model of this structure. Okay, so now what of this cluster? So what we do is, we go back, and now we have to download the zero cluster model from this link, and the 7th cluster model from this link, right? Also, there is a link to download all the, here you can download all the models, right, for all the coefficient in the sense balanced, electrostatic, all these four. As we have chosen two models which belongs to clusters 0 and 7, we can download them, and we need to compare them with some previously known information to choose the correct model. So now let's see how to view the downloaded docked structure. Docked files are now downloaded. It is recommended to view the files in PyMOL visualization tool to know the interactions and to get the image. But here I'll tell you some simple way to get the publication type image and to read their interactions. One is, first go to RasMOL and you download the file. Here, RasMOL background will be dark blue in color. What I have done is, in this command window, I have just typed background white. So once you type this one, your background will change to white color. Then what you do, color change. So you, both of your chains will appear in now different, the two proteins will appear in now different colors. Here you can either take this image, or you can go display molecular surface. You get this one, right? So either you can display it in cartoons, or you can display it in molecular surface to get a publication type image. Next, to view the interactions, open PDBSum. So here, click this link to get into the home page. So here you can see the home page, and now go to this generate. When you click this one, you can see a page like this where you can upload a file and type your mail ID. Now what you do is, when you upload this file, your work will go in a queue, right? You will get the results in your mail. So when you get this one, open through this link. This is PDBSum result page. Now you can see your complex protein uploaded and the protein chains, right? Here, now to know about their interactions, click this protein. This diagram gives you how many number of salt bridges, hydrogen bonds and non-bonded contacts are there. You can see the numbers over here. How many residues are involved here in these two proteins. Coming down, here you can see which are the residues which interact with each other, right? So here the color will tell you what are the type of bonds here. And now here the residues are given. You can know about the residue interactions. To know to the atomic level, click here, list of interactions. Here you can see. So this is the chain. Chain A and chain E are there. So here, what is the residue name? Okay, and which atom of it is interacting with which atom of the other protein's residue. So here you can see the list. So first one will be hydrogen bonds, okay, and then you can see non-bonded contacts. We saw 135 are there, and the salt bridges form between which residue and their atoms. So this is how, here if you have prior information on which residues interact with each other, means when the two proteins form a complex, which residues interact. If you have that information, you can now check your models to see whether those residues are interacting and choose that correct model. But if you are not having any information, prior information, it is better to go with the first model, that is the zeroth cluster model. So we have seen now about ClassPro, the algorithm behind the working of this tool, how to submit our proteins and how to get a docked model. Thank you for watching.